Famous singer Justin Timberlake once eloquently stated, "What goes around, goes around, goes around, comes all the way back around." While some of you think that this song is about the karma of a bad lover, I choose to interpret it as being about my favorite toy, the yo-yo. But where did the yo-yo actually come from? To examine the history of the yo-yo, we must spin back the clock of time to ancient cultures such as China and Egypt. Then, let's unwind how it was reborn in the modern society, and finally, wrap up with some modern aspects and variations of the toy. So, spinning history backwards, we see that the strings of yo-yo origin run to China, where it is believed that the yo-yo first came into existence. However, according to the Museum of Yo-Yo History, which is a website completely dedicated to answering any questions about yo-yos you could possibly ask, but probably won't, the first historical mention of the yo-yo dates back to 500 BC in ancient Greece. And these Greek yo-yos, they could have been made out of wood or metal, but they were mainly made out of painted terracotta, and they were mostly used by children in ceremonies. Because when the children came of age, they would offer the toys of their youth, like yo-yos, to the Greek gods as a sacrifice. And because the discs were so fragile, most people just assumed that the Greeks used them for ceremonial purposes rather than actual play. Another popular story about the yo-yo is that it is a centuries-old weapon of the Philippines. The story tells of an assailant sitting in a tree with a heavily oversized yo-yo, and at a critical moment, the yo-yo would be hurled at the victim, presumably rendering him unconscious. As you can tell, the yo-yo has many deeply placed threads in various cultures. But how did it all unwind into modern society, specifically America? Starting in the 1700s, the yo-yo was widespread in every continent except for North America and Antarctica. Various regions had their own spins on the yo-yo. For example, India had the chukki, France had the bandolier, and England had the quiz. However, one country's version was exceptional, and it was from the Philippines again. They started using premium quality materials, such as silver, gold, and rare kinds of wood to create children's toys. Eventually, it became a national pastime. These ideas, they started spreading across the world over some time, eventually to a point where a man named Pedro Flores brought the first Filipino yo-yo into the US in the 1920s. And soon, Pedro started attracting crowds because he was playing with a toy that no one had ever seen before. According to Idea Finder, Pedro's idea for the name yo-yo came from the situation, which meant crowd. And seeing all this craze, Pedro decided to create a company in 1928 that made these toys. And about a year or so later, a businessman named Donald F. Duncan came and bought the company for $250,000. This was in 1929. And Duncan later evolved, or in this case, revolved the company into the Duncan Yo-Yo Company. So this is the company that started bringing in even newer kinds of yo-yos to the industry, like plastic and butterfly yo-yos. This company completely revolutionized the face of this toy for the next 80 years. And wrapping up, there are so many different modern aspects to this toy. People have started to create their own versions, like a metal drifter that just glides on any kind of material, or a yo-yo ball which can bounce once you let it off the string, and you can catch it again. People have taken this activity to new heights, or in this case, lows, by performing in world-class competitions. For example, in the annual World Yo-Yo Contest hosted in Tokyo in 2015, why they didn't call it the Toki Yo-Yo Contest? But what I do know is that there are some very competitive yo-yo players. The competition between these people has went as far as creating a Division I competition for the world. Think of that division as a SEAL Team 6 of the yo-yo world. And some of the tricks that these people perform would make all of our heads spin. And most of them have pretty creative names, like Time Warp, Brain Twister, and Split the Atom. Overall, development of new and fresh ideas for the toy over the course of history have been quite interesting and have expanded the yo-yo's impact on the world. So, as you can see, the history of the yo-yo is more than just being a simple toy. Yo-yos were children's toys and weapons before they re-emerged into modern society